As a graduate student, you have the opportunity to get into research and kind of get to the edge of what mankind understands. And that's really invigorating, you know, when you start to look into a problem and you realize that nobody else actually understands the solution to this problem. And you get to push that forefront of knowledge. The AeroLab specializes in computational and analytical aerodynamics, both for subsonic aircraft as well as supersonic. We also have some students even looking at orbital mechanics and spacecraft design.
So I came to Utah State because of the AeroLab specifically and the work that Dr. Hunsaker is doing in the lab. My work as a PhD candidate is to develop simple but accurate aerodynamic tools to better predict the performance of morphing wing aircraft.
Morphing in general means an airplane that can change shape during flight.
The morphing wing technology that we are researching can benefit the military because it leads to better controllable or less visible to radar aircraft. And then it benefits society as a whole because it can lead to more fuel efficient aircraft, which benefits the environment and everyone.
In the supersonic regime, we're looking at small changes in the geometry because those changes make a big impact on the sonic boom that is heard on the ground. So that instead of shattering windows, it may sound more like a rumble of thunder as a supersonic aircraft goes overhead.
We are trying to find a better wing design for aircraft. There are two different types of air resistance that affects the aircraft. So what I'm trying to do is find the optimum design that balances between the two air resistance types and the difference and how they affect each other.
Working with the AeroLab, I've had the opportunity to work with world-class scientists at organizations like the Air Force Research Laboratory, and I'm currently working with scientists at NASA in California, and I'll have the opportunity this summer and the following two summers to go on-site at NASA and work with scientists there.
So we work closely with the Air Force Research Lab, we work closely with NASA, we have collaborations with Texas A&M and Boeing. So after graduation, students have the opportunity to move on to an academic setting or industry or even go to a national lab.
One of the things I like best about my research is that it gives me an opportunity to approach problems that aren't understood and work to understand them.
I think that's really exciting for students. Anything that they're interested in and know that they can solve problems, that they can dissect problems, they can think through problems, and come up with solutions that can have a big impact on mankind.